to it.
Lily.
Around the corner.
Oh, hello.
What is this aligned for?
The queen has arrived.
Why are they here?
I think they want brunch.
She's so much smaller than I thought.
Beautiful.
And you got your pants.
I got pants. Oh, I brought two pairs. Oh, they only allow gorgeous people.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, I love your jacket. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hello,
good morning. Good morning.
Thank you. Thank you for all that you do.
Oh, you're kind. Good morning. Good morning.
Oh, look. And there's that little
dog. Hey, don't let go of her. Here. Good girl.
Want to sign that?
I would love it, but it's got a pen. Anybody have a pen?
No, I got a pencil.
Yeah, right.
With no eraser.
Come on, Valerie, you got a pen? Pocketbooks and no pen.
We were told to have tiny little guys.
I have a pen. She got one already.
Terry. T-E-R-I. Been listening to you since I was 20 years old. Driving to college.
Neither one of us is at all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, got a car.
Oh, and a driver's license?
I won't get in.
Oh, stop, stop. I'm thinking.
Okay, so are you guys filling out cards? I need questions, or you know me, I'll have nothing to say.
Oh, right.
We're all worried about that.
Fill out the card.
Really?
Ask a few questions.
Naughty questions. I like the anonymity of it. You don't have to raise your hand, right?
All right, I'll see you soon. Thank you.
All right, so why are you here?
I'm here to see Dr. Laura.
And what is it about Dr. Laura's word or message to you, the listener, maybe even the caller, that you know matters most?
The callers, and it, that kind of reflect to you know what I feel right now.
Now this
at
lady
the
behind you really wants to say something, so go for it.
We're celebrating our 52nd anniversary.
Congratulations. And that means you were married in what year?
In
72.
Wow, yeah, that okay. was 3 years before I was
52 years
2 years
ago,
before I was born.
And wow. And Dr. Laura encourages women to be kind to their husbands, so I think he's got the direct benefit of that.
That is amazing.
And she's been very helpful during some of the more rocky, difficult times of life. And I thought, what would Dr. Laura do? And that's helped guide
wonderful.
How I handled things.
Thank you. What about that?
I'm just here for the climate.
It is nice. Where are you guys visiting from?
Phoenix, Arizona.
Phoenix, Arizona. Really, lots of listeners there. The old KFYI day or KFYI days, right?
He's here for the brownie points.
Nice. All right, folks, what brings you here?
So I've been a Dr. Laura fan. She honestly is my hero and my second mother. I adore her. I'm just, like, so emotional just to be here, just to see her. I mean, everyone here, I'm sure, feels the same way, but I love her.
Well, let's
her.
Ask. Do you feel that same way?
Yes. I'm here because my friend Gina got me the tickets
nice.
To get in. But I've been married for 30 years, and I've been listening to Dr. Laura my entire married life, and she's giving me advice for every phase of my life, from like marriage, raising my kids, now my kids are adults, and I can take something from almost 99% of her phone calls. Love you, Dr. Laura.
Wonderful. Thank you. Brings you ladies here.
Well, I raised my kids on Dr. Laura.
Nice. Is this one of your kids?
This is one. She's the one now that listens to the whole podcast, and she got me the ticket so that we're here for this.
Wonderful.
Dr. Laura helped me raise these children. I raised great kids, and it was a lot of it was the help of her. So.
Do you agree with everything your mom said?
She pretty much just said what I was going to say.
Okay, good. Just checking.
Besides my mom, she's been a huge part of who I am today.
Wonderful. Thank you. Hello, all. How's it going?
Hello.
You're on camera, but you'll be on camera in there, so just get used to it. All right, what brings you today?
We're all longtime listeners.
Since we were teenagers.
Wow. Are you visiting from near or far?
Orange County.
Orange County, that's right. Excellent.
We've raised lots of ugly kids on her advice.
Do they all work at Disneyland now? Not very far, maybe?
No.
Okay. No.
Awesome. Thank you for coming. Hello.
Hi.
You guys together?
Yes.
Excellent. All right, what brings you here?
I've been listening to Dr. Laura since I was 19 years old on KFI, so that's been like 30 years now, and we think a lot alike. Glad to see her.
Wonderful. Glad you're here. And where are you visiting from?
We're from the Inland Empire, Riverside County.
IE. All right, nice. All right. Hello again.
Hi there. How are you?
All right, good. And what brings you here?
Big fan. Same thing. Probably decades listening to her. Also a huge live radio fan, terrestrial or otherwise.
Very nice.
Satellite. Been married 33 years. And
35.
And I'm kind of a
good job.
I'm probably a bigger fan than Sue, but she's a big fan too.
Wonderful. Where are you visiting from?
Ventura County.
Ventura County. All right. The 805. Excellent.
805. Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Where are you guys visiting from?
I'm from Bakersfield.
Bakersfield. All right, excellent. There's two great things from Bakersfield, other than you folks visiting. My favorite race car driver, Kevin Harvick, he's all now retired, and some guy in a band, but we'll just ignore what band that is. All right, so what brings you here today? You big Dr. Laura fans?
I'm a big Dr. Laura fan. Long-time listener.
He's been listening for 40.
40 years.
Wow,
yeah,
that's
right.
Amazing.
And yes, and I'm his girlfriend, and I'm a new listener, but I really love Dr. Laura's.
We love it. It's amazing. I've been, producing the calls for the show for about a decade now, and it's always amazing when we get new listeners almost every single week.
You guys do a great job. It's a fantastic
Thank
show.
You very
really
much.
Enjoyed
and
it.
I've been reading her book. So, yeah.
Good.
She's great.
Excellent.
Really enjoy her show. She's
well,
fantastic.
Thank you for being here today.
Yeah, thank you.
Get two more, all right? You guys together?
Nope.
You
want
to be together? No, it's good. All right, I'll start with you first.
Hi,
where are you visiting from?
Riverside.
Riverside, all right. Way out in Riverside. And what are you hoping to see and witness today with Dr. Laura?
Just more wisdom from her, as usual. Yeah, I'm excited. This is my first time meeting her, first time to her show. I'm just so excited.
Wonderful. And how about yourself?
I'm from Orange County, and she helped me when I was working to get through all the traffic every day. So
nice.
There we go.
Well, what was it, the old KFI days then?
Yes, it was, actually.
Okay. One more. Where are you visiting from?
Hi. Originally started listening to Dr. Laura on WMAL in Washington, D.C.
Wow, okay.
So that would be 91 when I was waiting in carpool line at a private school, and she was pro-private school at the time, so I was like, thumbs up.
Excellent.
And I was a stay-at-home mom, and it was great to have that connection. And now Orange County, Newport Beach, really happy to come up here and see this. So
well, thank you for being here.
Oh, my pleasure.
Let's do restrooms first, I think. Or no?
I feel like they
can... Okay, fair.
Of course. Yeah, of course.
We'll put it, send it out to family members, and it'll be on YouTube in 2 weeks.
I don't want you.
Hello.
Hello.
Some of
Hi.
Them. Last time I was in Crossroads, I saw two.
Hello. Okay, who do y'all here to see?
Dr. Laura.
I'm sorry, I cannot hear you. And when do you want to see her?
Now!
I'll give you 6 minutes.
Go out.
Any final words?
Yes, I meant to do good.
Thank you.
news or I'm not pretty enough. If it's funny, the TV was on in the so-called green room that isn't green. And I always get confused by that. As long as there's food in it, though, I'm good. Woman, but okay, we're going to leave that aside for right now. We have a whole day for I don't know what. It's all in your mind anyway. And they were just showing products to look prettier to somebody. And most people don't care. And if you somebody sees somebody pointing at you and going, see your thighs wiggle.
Yes, I am.
Yeah, you're wrong.
All right, okay. Cool. What is your name?
Kathy Holmes.
Kathy, where'd you come from?
Phoenix, Arizona.
Wow.
We flew in this morning.
Are you kidding? That's amazing. How long have you been a Dr. Allura listener?
For almost 20 years.
Okay. And what was your question today? Do you mind sharing which one? You don't have to.
I didn't have a question today, but we're here celebrating our 52nd anniversary.
Wonderful.
And
congratulations.
My husband was here, too.
Yes, I saw him.
He's here for brownie points.
Oh, that's fabulous. What's your favorite piece of Dr. Laura advice?
Yeah. What's my
favorite piece of Dr. Laura advice that you've ever had?
Would you like to be interviewed? Be kind.
Because you made it to 52 years, so you're obviously practicing that, right?
I tell my husband he's the beneficiary.
Very nice. Well, thank you for coming today.
Thank
I hope you.
You
enjoy the rest of your time in Southern California.
Thanks.
Bye.
I'm here. I'm from L.A.
Oh, perfect! How long have you been a Dr. Laura listener?
For 30 years, I think. I mean, ever since I got married, and I've been married for 30 years. So
congratulations.
As I said earlier, she helped me navigate, you know, marriage, raising my kids. My kids are adults now. And I still make them listen, and they love Dr. Laura. My friend got me tickets to come with
her. Nice.
And when they said that I was coming, they're like, "Oh, Mom, we love Dr. Laura. It's so fun to go see her." And I make them listen.
Do they live here?
Or nearby? My oldest daughter lives here in L.A., and my son lives in New York. I miss him a lot.
So maybe they can come to the next show.
Maybe.
There's 4 years. So.
Oh,
What's your favorite piece of Dr. Laura advice?
My favorite piece today or just in general?
In general.
I just think anything to do with marriage and parenting, because that's kind of where I am, and I just retired. Mm-hmm. So I love to hear all her advice that she gives for people in this next stage of our lives. And I worked part-time when my kids were young, and it was because of Dr. Laura.
Very wonderful. Yeah. Congratulations.
I was a teacher for 30 years.
Did you know she did a deep dive on retirement? So you can listen to that sometime.
Is it what?
She did a deep dive, which is like an hour-long podcast on retirement.
I know. I need to listen to that because I just retired. I'm just a retired teacher.
Oh, okay.
I taught for 30 years.
Wow.
And now I'm just kind of navigating that part of my life now.
Congratulations.
Figuring out the next stage.
Oh, well, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
San Diego. Okay, me too.
Oh, really?
Did you take the train in this morning?
No, we drove.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Good. And how long have you been a Dr. Laura fan?
I'm going to be 38 this year, and since I was 6.
Wow. Why
so.
Why 6? Your mom drove
my
you
mom.
In the... Oh, you were with her?
Come on.
Oh, you don't have to.
You just said something.
Oh, Mom. I love the mom and daughter times together. And so, do you have kids?
No kids.
No, not yet. Okay,
not yet.
So
I have a niece. Yeah.
What is your favorite Dr. Laura advice that maybe you've applied to your life?
Gosh, everything. Honestly, like, I've probably broken some of the rules, if I'm being honest, but I think just, like, trying your best and, like, taking, you know, like, not taking life too seriously, even though it can be serious.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the morals and values thing, like treating other people like you want to be treated,
mm-hmm.
and kind of being a little harsh with yourself where
Thank
it makes
you.
Sense. But I just appreciate, like, all the practical advice. And when we had questions today, I was like, I don't know what to ask her because I feel like I know what she'd say.
Exactly.
And for listening for 30 years. But, yeah, I think she's honestly shaped my life. Her plus my mom. It's like a running, like, track in my brain. So really appreciate it.
I love it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for
you
having
have
us.
Have a safe trip home.
Thanks.
Get your name and where you're from.
Sure. My name is Fumi. I came from Orange County today.
Okay, nice.
And I always listen to SiriusXM and
all the
live, whenever I have, I'm able to.
How long have you been a Dr. Laura listener?
It's been about like 2 years, probably.
Okay. How did you discover her?
I went through rough times during the past 2 years.
Yes.
And then personally, it was just
Did you just happen the channel?
I just happened to have the channel, and then I started listening, and I was listening to the callers, and then kind of relating to the situation that I've been through.
Okay.
And,
has it been helpful?
It's been very helpful. You know, it's because I'm self-employed, usually I don't really talk to so many people, you know, or ask for advices and all that, but, you know, listening to the callers, listening to some of the words of wisdom that Dr. Lola says.
Have you ever called in?
No, I haven't.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you could. You should. You can write in, too. You can just write a letter.
But, it's been a pleasure just being here, listening to her. It's been very inspiring.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
And have a safe drive back to Orange County.
I sure will.
All right.
Thank you.
Debbie Raven from Newport Beach.
Okay.
And I've been watching Dr. Laura, listening to Dr. Laura since the early 90s in Washington, D.C. on terrestrial radio.
Wow.
And she has informed my life and educated me in so many ways and proved me right in other things, which I'm really happy about. But this was a lot of fun. This was on my bucket list.
Yay. Is there some kind of Dr. Laura advice that you'd like to share with others?
Probably, but it's eluding me right now. But just her mannerisms, her confidence, and I have followed her advice. I called up twice.
Oh, okay.
The first time she told me to, really break bad on my son, I did. Instantly, I got the reaction that I wanted, as she said I would. And the second time, she yelled at me, and I just ripped her.
Okay. So were you upset that day when she yelled? Were you upset when you got the
feedback?
Yeah,
I was very upset with my husband, and he was not really to blame at that point, which
she corrected you.
Corrected me, yeah. And it was helpful because our marriage is really great, and I think a lot of that I owe to listening to Dr. Laura. She's my nice, calm place.
And so would you encourage people to call in? You know, what do you think?
You want a problem solved really fast or simplified and broken down for you really fast, you need to call.
Thank you for sharing.
Oh, no problem. Thank you.
It's nice to meet you. Bye. I'm looking sharp.
I'm Stephen Myers from Chino Hills.
Okay. And what brought you here today?
Finally see the lady I've been listening to over 30 years.
Over 30 years. Yeah. Have you ever called in, like the last lady?
I called in once, but I choked.
Oh.
And she had no choice to put me on hold, which means I'm getting hung up on.
But did you?
I had it coming.
Were you able to get your problem solved by listening to other callers?
She solved more problems for me than anything. Books she wrote, my wife almost threw it at me, but she finally read it and it helped her a great deal.
The proper care and feeding of husbands? Oh, yes. That's wonderful. Is she here with you today?
Unfortunately, I lost her 2 years ago
with
cancer.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that.
But for the last remaining, she finally read that book.
Wow.
And it did make a difference.
I'm so happy for you that she was able to listen to you, hear you, and treat you kindly, right?
Usually I get the reaction of, you listen to Dr. Laura? And even though it's been almost 3 years now, and even I just recently started dating again, and I just dated a girl yesterday, and I shared with her, which is actually a test, but I let her know I listen to Dr. Laura,
mm-hmm.
and I go by that reaction. If it's negative, that's a red flag.
I love that. Thank you for sharing. That's an amazing clip. Well, we're so glad that you made it here today.
Great.
And have a safe drive home, okay?
Thank you.
Congratulations on winning your hat. Where are you guys from?
We're from Brentwood,
California.
Oh, okay. Northern
California.
Northern California,
yeah. And how long have you been listening to Dr. Laura?
Myself, around 1992.
Okay.
And I was turned on by a coworker who used to go to her car on her lunch break. And I'm like, what do you do out there? And she's like, I listen to Dr. Laura. I'm like, well, who's that? And so it just snowballed from there.
That's amazing. And then did you introduce her to him?
Yes, that's exactly how it happened.
That's how it happened. Okay.
That's a lot of our communications during the day. Oh, my God. He'll call. Did you hear that call?
Did you hear what
she said?
I told you I was right.
Have you ever called in?
No. No.
Written in?
No.
Okay.
No, because everything I have in my head, she answers eventually, okay. Honestly. So.
Mm-hmm. So we don't waste
yeah.
the time.
Yeah.
Right, but, and then we
yeah.
usually, like, with her sisters, she'll be like, I got to talk to Larry or you about Dr. Laura.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I need some Dr. Laura
yeah.
advice.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh,
I'm like,
okay.
This is what she would say. So
what would Dr.
This is
Laura
what
say?
I did.
What's the biggest piece of advice of hers that you've applied to your life?
I know what it is for me. When I get up in the morning, I know that she's smiling at me, and when I come home, I don't even hit the front door, and she's on me.
Oh.
Every day.
Treat kindly. Very
every
nice.
Day.
Yes. That is, he's
that's
right.
For
that's
me,
it.
For me, it is.
Wonderful. What about you?
I would have to say, probably, she changed my life when she said, between now and dead, is this how you want your life to be? And I quickly changed it after that.
That's amazing.
And we're 20 years later.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Yeah,
thank you.
All right, let's
page
take a picture.
Of
good morning.
Oh, Jennifer.
Jennifer.
Galay.
Galay,
and we
okay.
came all the way from Menifee, California.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, and how long have you been listening to Dr. Laura?
Me for about 4 years.
Well, I heard of her back when the book came out, 10 Stupid Things
Women
Do.
Oh, my gosh.
Lives.
So
and
so
she
the very
gifted
beginning.
Me that book.
Yes.
And so that was introduction for
yeah.
me. Yeah.
That was a long time ago. That was that book is actually going to be 30 years old this year.
What?
This is the
yeah,
30th
yeah.
anniversary
wow.
of that book.
Wow.
So she bought it for me when I was a teen. But
yeah.
I wish I would have read it at that age. But
you know what? I bought it for my 18-year-old daughter. She hasn't read it yet.
Yeah. So now I'm pushing my 16-year-old to read it, though.
Good.
Yeah,
very,
so,
very
yeah.
good. So what is your favorite bit of advice from Dr. Laura?
The best thing that I hold on to and I want my kids to follow is the not checking up. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. That's like huge for me.
What
well,
about you?
Have fun.
Yeah.
Just do the best. And for me, I'm up there in the 60s, so pack up as much as you can in life. Because
yeah.
you don't want to regret things you didn't do.
Yep, like
yeah.
she was saying,
yeah.
don't leave anything on
the
table.
Don't leave anything on the table.
Yeah, we like
exactly.
that. Yeah, I kept
yeah.
kind of nudging at her, too, like you see,
yeah.
trying to encourage her.
And do your kids listen?
Yes.
Okay.
I was telling Dr. Laura that hopefully we can do a teen segment, because my 16-year-old was actually bummed that she couldn't
she
make
couldn't
it
come.
Today. Yeah. That she couldn't
oh, because she
yeah,
can't
18.
Be 18
yeah.
per SiriusXM.
Yeah, but we all listen in the car all
oh,
the time.
Wonderful.
And I'll even listen to our 11 o'clock and then the 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
Even if it's
she
the
can't
same.
Get enough.
Yeah.
Do you listen to the call of day and the deep dives?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
I'm trying to think if there's like a favorite call of the day. I feel like the one, I think she brought one up recently where it had to do with... Gosh, she was talking about it at the beginning.
I was just noticing your...
My mind was going blank.
Yeah, I don't know.
I feel like she talked about it in the beginning of today. She kind of recapped. Yeah,
nice.
A call from a couple of days
well,
ago.
Well, thank you for being a fan. Thank you for coming all the way out. And then you were a couple years away from your child being able to come here.
Yeah,
yeah.
So hopefully...
She'll come the next time around.
What did
yeah,
she say when you said bring teens?
She like... Oh, Dr. Laura? She's like, yeah, I might have to. So.
I think that would be a good idea.
And yeah, because like the 10 stupid things women do to mess up their lives, I feel like, and then the 10 stupid things men do to mess up their lives, I feel, and I even told my daughter that I wanted to get her boyfriend that book,
mm-hmm.
because I feel like why not do it now as far as like implementing everything that's in the book versus waiting while they're in their 20s and they
yeah.
think they really know it all by then.
Wait till you do the thing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's wonderful.
Okay.
I'll talk to her about
thank
that.
You.
Maybe
yeah.
we can do.
My name is Lisa London and I'm from here. From
oh,
Los
okay.
Angeles.
So you didn't have to drive too far.
No.
Nice. And how long have you been listening to Dr. Laura?
You know, I'm actually new at listening to Dr.
And
Laura.
And how did that happen?
Because my boyfriend, who I have been with for 8 months, has listened to her for like 30 years and he turned me on to her.
Okay.
He was
so it's working?
Well, let me say yes, for sure. But a lot of things that she says kind of validated what I have learned from the past, my mistakes,
okay.
bad relationships that I've made, choices.
Your understanding.
Yeah, so this, you know, a lot of things when she talks about care and admiration and, you know, support and love and those kind of things in her books, I feel like I learned from my errors and I'm doing that.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
So what is your favorite tip or Dr. Laura advice?
You know, mine is really, I love, I'm reading two, I have one of her, I forgot if it's, is it called Live Life, that one book?
Yes. Yeah, that was the last one.
Mm-hmm. That I'm reading now. I just took it off his bookshelf.
Okay.
But my favorite tip is just really about, when it comes to relationships, it's really important to, you know, care, have the care factor, and really the admiration and the support that you feel for the other person. And that's really how I feel about my boyfriend.
So
I feel that's some of the best advice, because there's no reason to nitpick and fight with somebody. It's all about communication and being able to see the other person's point of view. And she talks about compromise, too. So that's really, I feel like when I read that, I go, oh, good, I've learned my lessons and I'm doing that well.
It sounds like you guys are on the right path.
Yeah, we had, and you know, she talked about it in there, about commonalities and compatibility and all that. So it was really important to me that, you know, I've been married and divorced and did a lot wrong, you know. So it's very important to me this time that I'm doing it right. And I feel good about it.
Yeah, like I said, I'm so happy for you. Thank you.